بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصابنا بسيدنا ومولانا أبي عبد الله الحسين عليه السلام، وجعلنا الله وإياكم من الطالبين بثأره بين يدي الإمام المنصور المؤيد المهدي من آل محمد. فلئن أخرتني الدهور وعاقني عن نصرك المقدور، ولم أكن لمن حاربك محاربا ولمن نصب لك العداوة مناصبا، ولا أندبنك صباحا ومساء، ولا أبكين لك بدل الدموع دما. لبيك داعي الله لبيك، لبيك يا حسين لبيك، إن كان لم يجبك بدني عند استغاثتك ولساني عند استنصارك، فقد أجابك قلبي وسمعي وبصري. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك، عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. The following is the narration of the final moments of the life of the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, the Imam who the verses in the Quran were revealed about. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Innama yuridullahu liyudhhiba ankum ar-rijsa ahla al-bayti wa yutahhirakum tathira. The man who the verse of the Quran was revealed about. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Qul la as'alukum alayhi ajran illa al-mawaddata fil-qurba. The man who the verse of the Quran was revealed about. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa yut'imun at-ta'ama ala hubbihi miskinan wa yateeman wa asira. إنما نطعمكم لوجه الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. The man who the verse and indeed the traditions mention him when the Holy Prophet peace be upon him and his family states, Hussein is from me and I am from Hussein. Allah loves the one who loves Hussein. The same Prophet who said, Hassan and Hussein are the masters of the youth of paradise. The same Prophet, peace be upon him and his family, who said, Hassan and Hussein are the leaders of this ummah, be they sitting or be they standing. When Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam had been killed, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam returned back towards the tent, and he saw the bodies of his companions lying on the floor. He saw the tents of his brother Aqil empty. He saw the tents of his brother Ja'far empty. He saw the bodies of his beloved, all of them killed in front of him. He then stood up in front of everyone and said, Ya Abbas ibn Ali, Ya Ali al-Akbar, Ya Habib ibn Mudahir, Ya Muslim ibn Awsaja, Ya Zuhair ibn al-Qain, Ya Abtal al-Safa, Wa Ya Liyuth al-Hayja, Ma li unadikum fala tasma'u wa ad'ukum fala tujibun antum niyamun arjukum tantabihun fahadihi nisa' al-bayt al-rasul faqad alahunna min ba'dikum an-nuhul faqumu an nawmatikum ayyuhal kiram wadfa'u an al-rasul al-tagat al-li'am. O Abbas, son of Ali, O Ali al-Akbar, O Habib ibn Mudahir, O Muslim ibn Awsaja, O Zuhair ibn al-Qain, O valiant warriors, O brave fighters, why is it that I call you but you don't hear me? Or I invite you but you don't answer me? If you are asleep, I urge you to wake up. For these are the granddaughters of Rasulullah about to be attacked. I urge you to wake up and protect them and defend them from their enemy that's coming towards them. When he said these lines, he then uttered his famous lines that affect us until today. Ala min nasirin yansuruna? Hal min nasirin yansuruna? أما من مذيب يذب عن حرم رسول الله هل من مغيث يغيثنا. Is there any helper to help us? Is there anyone to come and support us? Is there anyone to come alongside us? Each one of us, Aba Abdullah, calls out to you, لبيك يا حسين. When he said these lines, he returned back towards the tent. The ladies of Al Muhammad began to wail, realizing the loneliness of Imam Al Hussein alayhi salam. All of a sudden in the tent, a voice was heard, the voice of Imam Ali ibn Al Hussein Zain Al Abidin alayhi salam. At this moment, Imam said, give me a sword and give me a stick. Why do you want a stick? Why do you want a sword? He said, a stick so I may stand up, and a sword that I may defend my father. At this moment, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam replied to the Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam by saying to him, you are the most pure and the most noble of my lineage after me. Come towards him, O people, pledge your allegiance to him. O Ali ibn al-Hussein, who will there be for the poor and the destitute and the orphans after me if you die? O Zainab, if Ali ibn al-Hussein dies, then know that there will be none of the lineage to remain after us. At that moment he called all of them and he said to them, come and pledge your allegiance to the Imam after me. Upon saying these words, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam then turned and he came towards Rabab and he came towards Zainab alayhi salam. He said to them, give me my baby, let me see my baby before I head out. They gave him the baby and he realized the amount of thirst that had affected the baby. So the Imam went out towards the plains of Karbala and he looked towards the opposition. He said to them, if you see me as your enemy, what has this 6-month-old baby done to any of you? At least try and quench the baby's thirst. At that moment there was disagreement amongst the members of the opposition. Some of them said, give some mercy towards the baby. Others said, kill the baby. Others said, kill the whole household. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam again came towards them with the baby, this time suggesting that he would leave the baby for them to quench the thirst. At that moment, nobody came forward and quenched. He took that baby the third time. When he took the baby, Umar bin Sa'd turned round to Harmala bin Kahil al-Asadi and he said, get your arrow ready, an arrow that will take out that baby. When Harmala bin Kahil was asked, which arrow did you use to kill the six-month-old baby of Hussein bin Ali? He said, I used the three-pronged arrow that we normally use to cut the neck of a camel. I ask you, how could a baby contain thirst with a camel that can contain its thirst? At that moment, Harmala bin Kahil says, I was waiting just to see some of the neck of that baby, for there was some cloth covering it. When I saw some of the neck of that baby, I then pulled back my arrow and I shot the baby, and I saw the baby's hands begin to flap like the wings of a bird. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam took the blood of that baby. He threw it up in the sky. According to one narration of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, he says, when Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam threw the blood in the sky, none of the blood came back, not even a single drop hit the earth. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam returned back with the baby. When he came back with the baby, there was some of the ladies in the tent. He gave the baby to Umm al-Masa'ib Zainab alayhi salam. Zainab alayhi salam took the baby. She went towards Rabab. She looked in the eyes of Rabab. She said to her, you know Ramla gave her son Qasim away. She said, yes. She said, and you know Layla gave Akbar away. She said, yes. And you know of the others who have given their sons away. She said, yes. Rabab looked at her and said, Zainab, tell me what's the news. Have I given mine away as well? At that moment, Sayyida Zainab consoled her and said to her, yes, your baby has been martyred. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam took the baby, and he buried the baby on the earth of Karbala. Then from that moment, Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, who was 3.5 years of age at Karbala, Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says that Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam came out onto the battlefield in Karbala, facing the army and facing the opposition, in what would be his first farewell message. He looked towards them and he said, O people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was angry with the Jews when they made Uzair the son of God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was angry with the Christians when they made Jesus the third of the three. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was angry with the Magians when they worshipped the sun on the moon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also be angry when you kill the son of the daughter of his prophet. But I will not accept or give in to your call. Rather, I will meet my Lord with this beard dyed in blood, with this beard covered in blood, and die the death of the prophets of Allah. When they heard this, the ladies of Al-Muhammad, you can imagine the sight for the daughters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, seeing the loneliness of Aba Abdullah. When he entered the tent, at the moment he entered, he saw them crying. He looked towards them and he said to them, O ladies, remain patient. Allah will support you and assist you and look after you and avenge what will happen to you. Remain patient in this moment, each and every one of you. He continued to talk to them one by one. He continued to speak to each of them one by one, until at that moment he said, who will give me my horse so I will go out on the battlefield? His sister Zainab alayhi salam came with the horse, And she looked at him and she said, "Have you ever seen a sister give a horse so that her brother goes towards his death?" His heart broke for Sayyida Zainab alayha salam. She then looked towards him, having given him the horse. She looked towards him. As he was leaving, she called out the lines that we remember every year. Mahlan, mahlan, yabna Zahra. Wait, wait, O son of Zahra. May Allah bless the patience of Fatima al-Zahra on a day like this, when she hears the masa'ib of her children on the plains of Karbala. Mahlan, mahlan, yabna Zahra. Wait, wait, O son of Zahra. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, heartbroken by the loneliness of Zainab alayhi salam, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam turned around towards Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam. He said to her, "What is it, my dear Zainab?" At that moment, Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam turned around and looked towards Medina. She looked towards the grave that all of us yearn to see one day, the grave of Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam, which only she and Hussein knew about at that time. She looked towards Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. She said to him, "Aba Abdullah, just before my mother Fatima died, she said to me, 'I have an amana for you.' She said, 'Give this shirt to Aba Abdullah. There will be a day he will be alone on the plains of Karbala. Give this shirt to him. Let him cover himself with the shirt.' I ask each and every one of you, did the shirt protect him from the hooves of the horses on Sham-e-Ghariban? Did that shirt protect him from those who kicked his body? Did that shirt protect him from those who attacked his body?" Then she said to him, "Let me kiss you." Where did she kiss him? It was an amana from her mother Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam. She kissed Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam on his chest. Then she kissed Imam al-Husayn. This is for all of you. You know where we are heading now. Then she kissed Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam on his neck, the same neck that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi used to kiss. She kissed Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam on his neck and on his chest. All of a sudden, Umar bin Sa'd, seeing the exchange between Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam and Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam, suddenly call out, "Attack his house, attack his tent with all the arrows that you have." Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, realizing that his children were about to be attacked and that he had no supporter left with him, left the tent, went towards the opposition, and he began to speak to them. "Am I not the grandson of Muhammad al-Mustafa? Is my grandfather not Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih? Is my grandmother not Khadija alayha salam? Is my mother not Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam? Is my great uncle not Hamza Sayyid al-Shuhada? Is my uncle not Ja'far al-Tayyar? Is my father not Ali ibn Abi Talib, the Lion of Allah? Do you deny all of this? Why have you come out to kill me if you know all of this?" They replied by saying, "We have come out to kill you out of hatred for your father." When he heard this, then after that, in an exchange with Umar bin Sa'd, according to certain narrators, he said to Umar bin Sa'd, "I have three requests from you." Umar bin Sa'd looked towards him and he said, "What are they?" He said, "The first of them is offer us some water. The second of them is allow our family to go back in peace to Medina. The third of them is fight us one on one." Umar bin Sa'd said, "As for the first one, you will die thirsty. I will not offer any of you any water. As for the second one, they will not be returned to anywhere for safety. As for the third one, we will fight you one-on-one. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam at this moment came out on the battlefield, facing thousands of soldiers standing there alone. But he came out and he valiantly said, "An al-Hussein ibn Ali, alaytan la anthani, ahmi ayalat abi, amdi ala deen al-Nabi." He came out and valiantly fought the opposition. Abdullah ibn Ammar ibn al-Yaghuth narrates, "I have never in my life seen a man as brave as Hussein ibn Ali. I have never seen a man as valiant and as courageous as Hussein ibn Ali. He pierced through our army one by one. And then when he headed to the Furat, he got to the Furat where Amr ibn Zabid had 4,000 soldiers. He made all of them leave the Furat, and he was there with his horse on the Furat. While he was there, each and every one of us knows, Aba Abdullah had not had a sip of water for a number of days. But look at the softness of the heart of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. When he came to the water of the Furat, he was about to drink from some of that water, and he noticed that his horse was thirsty, and he could not take seeing a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thirsty. He offered some water to the horse, and the horse would not take it. Imam again offered some water, and the horse would not take it. All of a sudden, Shimr bin Dhil Jawshan, knowing very well, alongside others, that if Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam is allowed to drink any water, then he will pierce through the opposition alone. So they called out, "Hussein, you drink water while your ladies are being attacked." It turned out to be a lie. The ladies were not being attacked. They had just done this because they knew how much Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam cared about the ladies of Al Muhammad. Imam rode his horse and he returned back to the tent. And when he came back, the ladies all gathered around him so they may get a final moment with Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. His sister Kulthum came towards him, and his sister Zainab came towards him, and the ladies of Al Muhammad, including Rabab and others, came towards him, and they sat with Imam. Some of them came and protected him. The Imam began to talk to all of them, but then they said to him, "Oh Imam, there is one who wants to talk to you more than any. Who is it?" "It's your daughter Sukayna alayha salam." Sukayna alayha salam, at that moment the narrators mention, she had her head between her knees and she was in deep thought and contemplation. She saw her father. She said to her father, "Oh father, why can we not now return back to Medina? Oh father, have you submitted yourself to death?" At that moment Imam al-Hussein replied that, "Oh Sukayna, I have no supporters left for me." But Sukayna remained strong, remained patient with what you're about to see. He bid farewell to Sukayna alayhi salam. Then he was about to leave. He heard Sukayna calling out, "Father, father, come back one final time." Every year we narrate this, it breaks our heart when we hear the following lines. He said to her, "Sukayna, what is it?" She said, "Father, normally when someone becomes an orphan, you pat them on their head." She said to him, "Father, pat me on my head, please." Imam al-Hussein patted his dear Sukayna on the head. He embraced his dear Sukayna at that moment, and he began to walk out on the battlefield. The thirst of Karbala began to overtake Aba Abdullah. He now was fighting valiantly in the late afternoon. It was coming to about an hour before Maghrib. He was fighting valiantly until Umar bin Sa'd said, spray him with all your arrows, attack him with whatever you can. Imagine that one by one, they were either throwing rocks on Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Some of them were throwing rocks on the head of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Others of them were trying to get their arrows towards the Imam. All of a sudden, Abu al-Hutuf al-Ja'fi managed to throw his rock on the forehead of Aba Abdullah, slicing the forehead of Aba Abdullah open. He broke the very forehead that used to be kissed by Rasulullah, the forehead that used to be touched by Fatima al-Zahra, the forehead that used to be prostrating next to Amir al-Mu'mineen. Imam al-Hussein's forehead had split open from the cut. He tried at that moment to remove the blood that came from him. All of a sudden, a man shot an arrow directly into the forehead of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. A man shot an arrow directly in the forehead of Imam al-Hussein. The blood began to pour onto the eyes of Imam al-Hussein. Like Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, both of them could not see because of the blood on their eyes. The blood began to pour on the forehead of Aba Abdullah. It now moved towards the eyes of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. He removed the helmet that he had on his head, and he removed the armor on his head. Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati rasulillah. The pain was too much for Aba Abdullah. He now fell from his horse directly on the ground. Imam al-Rida alayhi salam says that my grandfather Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam was not killed. My grandfather Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam was slaughtered. When somebody is killed, they are killed directly at that moment. But when they are slaughtered, they go through an immense amount of pain before their death. He was rolling on the ground in Karbala. One of the narrators sent by Yazid says Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam looked like a hedgehog from the amount of arrows that were now on his body. He was not even able to move one side or the other. He tried to get some of the sand of Karbala so that he could put his head on that sand. He now lay there on the ground, reciting supplications and talking to his Lord. In reality, O Allah, what did I find when I lost you? And what did I lose when I found you? One line of the lines that he said. One line of the lines. One line of the lines that he said is a line that breaks my heart every time I hear it. صبرا على قضاك لا معيد سواك. Patience over what you have willed. There is no helper like you, O Allah. Whenever you go through any moment of difficulty and someone says to you, remain patient, have sabr, never forget that there is no sabr like the sabr of Aba Abdullah. He simply lay there on the ground and he called out, sabran ala qadak la bu'ida siwa. Patience, O Allah, with what you've ordained. If this is what you've willed, then I am pleased with what you've willed. There is no supporter like you, O Allah. He lay there on the ground. There was hardly a breath coming out of the mouth of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Shimr bin Diljoshan did not know if Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam was dead or was the Imam alive. So at that moment Shimr said, attack his woman on the tents. Attack his woman in the tents. At this moment we'll know if he's dead or if he's alive. If he's alive, there's no way Aba Abdullah will allow anyone to touch Zainab alayhi salam. There's no way him or Abbas would have allowed anyone to touch Zainab alayhi salam. So at that moment, what did he call out? He called out at that moment, attack his woman. Can you imagine the fear going through the heart of Sukayna alayhi salam? The moment Imam al-Husayn heard this, he tried to stand up, but he fell. He tried to stand up again and he fell. He tried to stand up and he called out, O army of Yazid, O army of Abu Sufyan, if you don't believe in God or a day of judgment, then at least be free men. What have these women done to you for you to attack them? At that moment, Shimr bin Diljoshan replied, leave his woman alone. From that moment onwards, different people tried to come and attack Aba Abdullah. At this moment, Umar bin Sa'ad turned around. He turned around towards Harmala bin Kahil. He said to him, Harmala, shoot the chest of Hussein ibn Ali and try and penetrate his heart. At this moment, Harmala bin Kahil, who had already shot the right eye of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, who had already taken out the six-month-old baby, Harmala bin Kahil says, I was getting my arrow ready, an arrow which was covered by poison, so I could kill Aba Abdullah. He said, at this moment, I saw a young man running out from the tent. He was Abdullah, the nephew of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, son of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. He ran out of the tent. His auntie Zainab called him, said, come back, come back. He said, how can I come back? And Aba Abdullah lies in Karbala alone. How can I come back and Imam al-Husayn is there alone? How can I come back and my beloved is on the earth alone? He went and he sat next to the body of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. He sat there and he placed his body opposite the body of Imam al-Husayn. When he did this, Harmala bin Kahil, with no mercy whatsoever, shot him at that moment. He fell next to his uncle Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Harmala bin Kahil got another arrow ready. He says, I waited until I could see the whiteness of the neck and the chest of Aba Abdullah. He said, at this moment I pulled back. The moment I pulled back, my arrow hit the heart of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. I want you, wherever you may be, to picture the forehead of Imam al-Husayn has an arrow inside it. The heart of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam has an arrow next to it. There are arrows all over the body of Imam al-Hussein. Imagine what Fatima al-Zahra felt seeing all of this. Imagine what Fatima al-Zahra felt seeing what they were doing to her son. Imagine what Al-Muhammad were going through at this moment. Umar bin Sa'ad kept on sending people. He said to them, finally go and kill the man. But every time a man would come to Imam al-Hussein, the moment he's about to strike him, some of them would say, we have never seen light like the light shining from the face of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. A Christian man in the army of Yazid says, I came with the intention of beheading Imam al-Hussein. He said, as I was about to, he looked at me and he said to me, oh man, do you know Mary? He said, yes. He said, do you know her son? He said, yes, Jesus. He said, oh man, my father is Ali, my mother is Fatima, and my grandfather is Muhammad. The man said, when I saw Hussein talk the way he was talking, I came back and I could not take it. There was no way I was going to kill Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. One by one, Imam al-Hussein began to be surrounded by soldiers, each one of them about to kill him. But whenever they would come near him, they would walk back, some of them because of his light, others because they would hear him whisper the Quran, others because they thought to themselves that how can we face his grandfather who we love and we believe in if they claim it, and we have killed the grandson of the man who we claim that we are the followers of. Sayyida Zainab alayha salam was looking towards the opposition. She looked towards the earth. She saw Imam al-Hussein going one way and the other. She saw he could not move. She said, oh Umar bin Sa'ad, how could you do this to Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam? Umar bin Sa'ad, realizing that Zainab's voice was getting louder, he began to turn around to those around him. May Allah give all of you patience for what I'm about to recite. Umar bin Sa'ad turned around. He said to all of those around him, one of you go towards him, one of you go and finish him. Enough is enough. Imagine the heart of Sukaina alayhi salam. She was thinking that my horse will come back any second with my father. Imagine the heart of Rabab alayhi salam. I've lost my baby, surely I can't lose my husband. Imagine the heart of Zainab alayhi salam. She's thinking that my backbone throughout my life is about to go. Imagine the heart of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. When many would come and recite the poetry, and al-walda wal-galab lahfan, wa-dawwar azabni wain ma-chan. Imagine the hearts of all of these. At this moment they called out, one of you go towards him. Suddenly Sinan bin Anas came one way, and Shimr bin Diljoshan came another. May all of you have patience at this moment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Imam Sahib al-Asri wal-Zaman. When he hears what I'm about to narrate, at this moment Sinan bin Anas came towards Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. He came towards the chest of Imam al-Hussein. One of them suddenly came and kicked Imam al-Hussein. Malik al-Nasri struck Imam al-Hussein once. Another trampled on the chest. Another began to hit the head. Sinan bin Anas got closer. Shimr bin Diljoshan closer. Fatima al-Zahra's heart can no longer take it. They came towards the chest, both of them coming together, until he pulled the neck of Imam al-Hussein. He pulled the beard of Sayyid al-Shuhada. He pulled the holy head. He pulled out his dagger and he took the neck. How many times did he strike the neck?
12 times, رحم الله من نادى وحسينا, رحم الله من نادى وشهيدا, رحم الله من نادى ومظلوما. Zainab fell on the ground at that moment. The same way her mother fell behind the door. This time Zainab fell on the floor. Leave my brother, leave him, leave my beloved Hussein, I beg you, leave him. Sukaina saw the horse returning back. She looked towards the horse. She said, "Oh horse, where's the rider that used to ride you?" Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون واللعنة الدائمة على القوم الظالمين. With your tears, my dear brothers and sisters, wherever you may be in the world, all of you, let's get together right now. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All of us in one voice. As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. All of you. وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته.